It's about 8:15 in the morning right now, and I am walking across town. I'm going river rafting today. I didn't bring my GoPro with me, so I can't really bring this camera on the boat. The guy said it'll probably get all wet. So there's probably not gonna be much video today, but yeah, river rafting.
Yeah, we're like, for some reason we misunderstand it with a driver, and the driver show up at like 8.
So that's all right. I was only there for 5 minutes. This.
Mine.
Yours. Okay. Next. Yeah. That's it. On. What is next?
Oh, that's mine.
How was the rafting trip?
The rafting trip was fucking amazing. I liked it.
So I just finished my rafting trip here in Tena, Ecuador. It was really great. Tour guide was awesome. We had a group of 6 people total, a Canadian woman, some Americans, a German, and a guy from Denmark. So yeah, it was a good little group, and highly recommended. Now I'm back in Tena. I'm gonna get some food. I'm starving right now. But there's this tower I just climbed, and so this is the view from the tower. Veggie burger and vegetarian burritos. I'm so hungry right now. So after river rafting today, I went to the vegetarian restaurant, the one and only vegetarian restaurant in town, and I ordered not just one, but 2 meals. Cost me $10. This is a vegetarian burrito, and this is a veggie burger. Look how big this thing is. It's as big as my freaking hand. Oh man, I'm gonna be so full tonight. So I'm at a waterfall slash swimming hole here in the Amazon rainforest in Ecuador. This place is awesome. There's no one here. I'm climbing up here to try to get to the waterfall, which is over there. You can't quite see it, but you can see the bottom of it right there. Feels so good. I'm at like a normal temperature right now. Not cold, not warm, just normal. Christmas morning here in Tena, Ecuador in the Amazon rainforest. I'm out on a bike ride and going along the river here. It's really hot when you're not in the shade, so at the moment I'm in the shade. It's pretty nice. Humid, but not too bad. So I'm on the bike path now. I discovered this bike route a couple days ago when I was walking around Tena on foot. But because I was on foot, I didn't really get to see where it went. So today we're gonna follow the path until the end. Well, the bike path didn't last very long, only 1 mile or so. I was hoping it'd be like 20 miles long. That would have been awesome. I guess 1 mile is better than nothing, but anyways, now I'm just cruising around in the jungle out here. So there's another bike path on my right. So the one bike path ended and I've picked up another one now. Let's see where this one takes me. Sun's out now, it's really hot. There's a bunch of butterflies right here. It's so hot. Hey. Hello. Look right there, there's a little gecko or a newt or something. Oh, he's really fast. I've never seen that before. He's really long. I thought it was a snake at first. Where'd he go? There he is. Hi. If you look closely right here, there are bananas growing in the wild. There they are. The lighting is really bad, but little bitty bananas. This is a flower. This actually looks like what bit me on the leg when I was in Baños. Something like that. It's really big. I think the secret to surviving here in the Amazon rainforest is whenever you see a body of water, jump into it. I just jump in with all my clothes on because then I can wear this on the bike and it'll keep me cool for a little bit at least. Oh man, it's so hot. So I've brought my bike just a short distance up the trail here into the rainforest. I'm gonna hike up this hill just for a little bit, like for 5 minutes, just to see where it goes. But I just wanted to get my bike off the road so no one would see it. So here we go. I told myself that I was just gonna go on a short little bike ride today. And now I'm doing a longer bike ride plus a hike through the forest. Then I gotta bike all the way back. This is what happens when you go out with me, is I always just keep saying, oh, let's go a little bit further, a little bit further. And then before you know it, we're way the heck far away. Which is a good thing to, if you're into bicycle touring, that's a good characteristic to have. Let's just keep going a little further. But when you're doing a loop and going back to where you began, the further you go on the journey out means the further you gotta come back. as cool as this is, I'm not gonna go any further. I just went a few minutes up the trail here. My bike is down there with my drone and wallet and camera and everything on it, so I don't wanna go too far. I brought the drone today, but I forgot the USB cable that I need to connect my smartphone to the controller. Ah, so I carried it all this way. This would have been the perfect place to fly it, and now I can't fly it because I'm missing one little cable. Whoops. Okay, good. My bike is still there. Bike, drone, helmet, it's all here. No problem. Going down is so much easier than going up. Oh my goodness. So I'm back on the paved road now, passing Universidad Regional Amazonica, Amazon University. Jumping in the water really helped. Like, I'm still a little bit wet. My shirt is getting dry, but my pants are still wet. It feels great. So I got back to my hotel just in time. It started pouring rain about 5 minutes before I got here, but look outside right now. It is coming down. Whew. I just took a shower, felt so good. So now I'm gonna hang in here until about 5:30 maybe, and then I'll go outside and try to find some food, but just gonna get some work done now. Hello amigos, Darren Alf here from BicycleTouringPro.com. I'm in Ecuador right now in the Amazon rainforest, sweating like crazy and loving it. I just wanted to make a quick video to wish everyone a happy new year and to reflect a little bit on my year past. At the beginning of this year, I spent the first 5 months or so recovering from cancer. Which was not a lot of fun. But then I went off on a 3-month-long bike tour in Europe where I rode through Portugal, Spain, France, Andorra, Norway, and Sweden along with three of my friends, Kevin, Ryan, and Sophie. And that was a great experience. I finished that trip, went back to California for more cancer diagnosis, follow-up stuff, and just a few months, about a month and a month and a half ago, I flew to Quito, Ecuador for the start of this bike tour. And on the new year, or on January 2nd or so, I'll start heading towards Colombia. So that's what my year looked like. Overall, maybe not the best year at the beginning, but it ended well. Oh yeah, I went to Alaska also. Which was awesome. I was there for 3 weeks. Forgot about that. So looking forward to 2017 now. I've said this before on Bicycle Touring Pro, but I'll say it again. The reason that I keep doing these bike tours year after year is because when I look back at the last 16 years that I've been doing this, it's the bike tours that I remember. The other stuff I've done in my life is not as memorable. I mean, I've published 4 books, I bought a house, I learned to ride a motorcycle, I've graduated from university, things like that. I moved to a new state. all of that is like secondary to my bike tours. So I'm encouraging you this year, whether you've gone on a bike tour or not in the past, I hope that you have a bike tour plan for the future. For this year, for 2017, not for 2023 or something crazy like that. This year, let's make it happen. 2017 is going to be my 10th year running Bicycle Touring Pro, and in that time I've helped thousands of people all around the world learn to conduct their dream bike tours. So if you want to go bike touring, check out my website, bicycletouringpro.com. Pick up a copy of my book, The Bicycle Touring Blueprint, and I hope to see you out there on the road.
Chicle, chicle, chicle. 44, 43, 42, 24, 23, 22, 21, 20, 19, 18, 17, 16, 15, 14, 13, 12, 11, vamos todos, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1,
about 2 weeks now. I spent both Christmas and New Year's here. I went rafting, went on a bunch of bike rides, went on some day hikes, ate at the vegetarian restaurant about 1,000 times, but now it is time to move on. I'm going to go north to the city of Coca and then north again into Colombia. So that's the plan from here on out. Colombia, here I come.